If you're even remotely curious about riding a motorcycle, you've probably spent at least a few hours flipping through your local Craigslist ads or Facebook Marketplace postings looking for something appropriate for a beginner rider. But then you got confused. Why are 650s slower than 600s even though they have bigger engines? Why does some guy on YouTube keep shouting that the best beginner bike ever made is a Turbo Hayabusa? Well, my inquisitive little barnacle friend, you've come to the right place because on today's So You Want a Blank video, we're gonna put together a nice little buyer's guide for your first motorcycle. But not just any old first motorcycle, no. If you want to spend the least amount of money possible and get the most bike for your dollar, then this video is for you. Today we're going to talk about what to look for and what you can expect from a $3,000 motorcycle you bought from the internet, what you should be avoiding, how you should go about acquiring said dirt cheap squid missile, and everything else in between. This is a question I get asked all the time, usually accompanied with an expired link to some clapped out looking 600 with a single word, thoughts, next to it. By the way, guys, don't do that. The only thought I have when seeing a message like that is loading you up in a catapult and watching you sailing off over the horizon with the age-old question of R3 or Ninja 400 echoing in the distance. I'm kidding, obviously. Your Papa Yam loves you, but sometimes you don't ask the right questions. Anyway, let's jump right into this video with a little bit of self-reflection. Now, I say self-reflection because there's a lot of things you need to consider before you pull the trigger on a dirt cheap bike on Craigslist. First of all, are you actually committed to riding a motorcycle? You might be sitting there thinking to yourself, Yam, of course I'm committed. That's why I'm here and I'm watching these videos. And if there isn't an Obi-Wan meme on screen right now, we'll be visibly confused. But you need to make sure you're ready to get involved with the nuts and bolts of owning a motorcycle, and I say that literally. Used bikes are not like used cars. They age much faster. Your first car was probably some crap box Honda Civic or some other Japanese sedan, or maybe a Mustang with more miles than a Greyhound bus, but the engine is wrapped in metal and the interior is safely tucked away from the elements and they tend to last a little bit longer. Motorcycles, by contrast, are very exposed to the elements, so rusted and seized bolts are really common. Cracked seats filled with gooch juice are the norm, and a pristine motorcycle is but a fevered dream of a madman or a Ducatista who locks it up in his garage. You need to be ready to do quite a bit of work on this bike, and since you're wanting to save money up front, you're probably not going to want to turn around and spend it in a mechanic shop, so there's a lot of peripherals you're going to need to get before you get the bike. Let's slap a quick little list in here for old time's sake. These are the must-have items you need to have before you buy your cheap starter bike. The first one is a factory service manual or a hands manual for the bike you're looking at. The second thing is a toolkit with all the tools you'll need to get the job done. As a shout out, Ari Henning has a great video on assembling your first toolkit if you want to check that out. A place to park and work on your motorcycle, a rear stand to lift said motorcycle off the ground, you're gonna need this anyway, and a friend who can help you work on the bike or some YouTube videos to help you out. There. Wasn't that nice? Now, if you're not able to get at least two or three of those things done before you buy your bike, you'll probably want to hold off a little, take some time and familiarize yourself with basic maintenance items on the model of bike that you want, and then gauge whether or not you feel comfortable doing those jobs yourself. Obviously, you're not going to dive right in with checking the valve clearance or swapping an engine, but you should be at least comfortable with taking your wheels off. If any of that sounds daunting to you and you don't have anyone you can ask questions to, then why not click the link down below and head over to yamnoob.co where you can join our Discord server. We've got tons of riders in there, from fresh-faced beginner squids to trusted and rusted out veterans talking about bikes 24/7. If you have a question about what bike you want, we've got a channel for that. If you got a question about fixing your ride, we've got a channel for that too. If you got a question about what gear you want to get, we've got a channel for that too. We're like a little app store, but for bikes. It's a great place to hang out and meet riders, and I'm there every day, so you can personally ask me whether you should start on a Ninja 400 or an R3. Not only that, but you'll be entered to win some motorcycles at the same time too, but if all you want is to win one of our bikes and get a t-shirt for your troubles, you can head over to yamanoobmerch.com where every dollar you spend is an entry to win, and just select your sweepstakes after checkout. But if all you want to see is the Turbo Hayabusa on this channel, you need to click subscribe and get us to 1 million subs when we shall ascend into the heavens with our Busa boy brethren. Now, if you've done all that stuff or you just thought YOLO and you skipped right into the middle of this video and next you're looking at getting your bike online, there's a lot of things to consider when looking at ads, so let's arm you with the tools you need to not run out and buy a steaming hunk of garbage. The first thing you'll see is a little thumbnail photo with some words about the bike. If the person is worth buying from, they'll include the year, make, and model of the bike. If they aren't, they'll include something like custom bike or motorcycle or super fast bike, usually with a photo that looks like it was taken from a mile away on a potato phone with head grease all over the camera lens. Trust me, my dudes, whatever motorcycle is being sold in that ad is not worth buying, even if it is ridiculously cheap. Speaking of ridiculously cheap bikes, beware of bikes that seem too good to be true. If you see a like new motorcycle being sold for way under value, that's a red hot indicator that that bike might be stolen. I'm not saying that's always the case, but let's be real, bikes are stolen all the time and flipped online, and you do not want to be caught riding around on a stolen motorcycle. Sometimes they might not be stolen, but they might have fatal flaws in them, like a blown head gasket or a cracked frame. But bikes being sold on the cheap are cheap for a reason. But how about a real world example? Well, let's take you to this 2012 Ninja 250 I found here in Austin, Texas for $2,500. Well, that's a perfect starter bike, right? You got manageable power, a dependable platform, and it's in the right budget. The owner even wrote a really nice description for the bike. Wrong! This is a race bike, and I can tell you from personal experience that the amount of crap you rip off on a bike in search of speed is comical. Just look at this thing. It has no lights, it has no license plate mount, it's got no kickstand, and if you're thinking about picking up some old track meal to use as a street bike, think again. Even secondhand, you're talking about thousands of dollars worth of parts to make it street legal again. No matter what the persons on the forums say, it is not easy work. You might be thinking to yourself that since it was an ex-race bike, it's got all the trick parts like a fancy master cylinder, tunes, exhaust system, and all those go-fast goodies that make it a bargain. But let me ask you this. Would you want someone turning your bike on and then immediately running it at redline for half an hour and then turning it off again? Well, my dudes and dudettes, that is the life of a race bike. They're all whipped like the red-headed stepchildren of rented mules. It is not worth the work. Which leads me to my next example. The 2005 Honda Shadow Spirit. The Shadow is a very good starter cruiser, if a little bit boring. Sure, it's an 1100cc engine, but it's more American 1100cc, so read that as slow. Now, once again, it looks to be in great shape from the photos. The mileage is pretty low for a 15-year-old motorcycle, and it's been garage kept. Heck, the owner's even thrown in a floor jack. But the problem is in the description. He says, "I haven't started this bike in 2 years." That's not good news. First of all, you can't take the bike for a test ride, which means you don't know what other gremlins the bike has. The owner doesn't say in the description why he hasn't ridden it in years, not to mention the owner didn't even bother to wheel it out of the garage to shoot the photos. That alone is disqualification enough, but beyond that, you're going to have to replace the tires, that's $300, do an oil change, that's $50, get a new battery, that's another $100, brake fluid needs to be replaced every 2 years, so that's another $50, so right there, you're at $3,000. If you're not comfortable doing those jobs and you need to take it to a shop, you're going to be well over budget. Your first bike should be in running order when you buy it. I know there's going to be a bunch of armchair mechanics down below saying that it's a piece of cake to get an old bike like this running again, but there's always someone who can fix a bike twice as fast as you and for half the price and with one beer in hand. Spend more time riding than wrenching for your first one. Next up, I found this 04 Yamaha FZ6, also for $2,500. This right here is the sort of motorcycle you should be looking for. First thing you see when you click the link is a shot of it in some dude's driveway out in the suburbs somewhere with a bunch of crap in the shot. You got a shot of the tires, you got a shot of the damage on the bike, and you got a shot of the dash showing the mileage. The owner has a great description and talks at length about the parts they've put onto the motorcycle. It's pretty clear this bike was well loved and taken care of. They've provided their reasons for selling the bike. You might be concerned at the fact that this bike has over 40,000 miles on the clock, but these Japanese inline fours are basically unkillable. It's a turnkey bike that someone with a little riding experience and a responsible throttle hand could probably handle. So now that you know what to look for online, it's time to go see the bike in person. Don't talk price over email or text, do it in person. Ask that they leave the bike cold for you so you can see if it's hard to start. When you get there, immediately check the engine to see if it's hot. If it is, walk away. If not, just start chatting the owner up and get them talking about the bike. If they put together a well thought out ad, chances are you're not going to learn anything more than them than you already know about the bike, but get them talking about the bike. See if they let slip anything that might be cause for concern. Start the bike up and let it get hot, listen for weird bangs or rattles in the engines, make sure the fans come on if it's liquid cooled, and make sure all the dash lights work and all that stuff. Walk around the bike and make sure it's safe to ride, then take it for a spin. Typically, in order to take a bike for a spin, the owner's probably going to want to see cash in hand or a check ready to go, typically cash in hand, so be mindful of that. Look over the title, make sure it's in the seller's name, and if there aren't any mistakes on it. Titling errors are costly and time-consuming to fix. If you have the purchase price in cash, it shouldn't be an issue. Just know that if you drop the bike, you're buying it. On the ride, test the brakes, the handling, and most importantly, make sure if it's comfortable and fits you. There's no sense in buying a bike you don't like. When you get back, that's when you start to negotiate. Give them your lowest number, but be respectful about it. If the bike has an NADA value of $2,500, don't give them $1,500 just because there's a dent in the tank. If they want $2,500, start at $2,000 and go from there. Once the deal's done, you ride off on a new steed and join the two-wheeled world. Or so you thought. Before you can have some fun on your bike, you usually have to get the bike inspected, get the title transferred at your local tax assessor's office, which usually involves paying sales tax on the bike, buy insurance for the bike, and take care of any outstanding maintenance item. This stuff sounds boring because it is, but they're the final loose ends on buying a used motorcycle, and you do have to do it. It's highly likely that your $2,500 motorcycle will cost an extra $500 in paperwork and state fees before all is said and done. It's a bummer, but we do all have to do it. But hey, once it's done, you'll be set and ready to go and ride off into the sunset with your brand new internet motorcycle. Fact: bedding was such a luxury in the Middle Ages that blankets and sheets were written into wills. Goodbye.
Keep watching, Yammy Noob. 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 Keep watching, Yammy Noob.